My people, on this day where the Father's Day, Uwazuruike has scattered the temple. Hey, hey, hey. Let's hear him out. Let's listen to him. Make me hear what he has to say.
It is a peaceful movement, 1999. What to, if we go out, then sure we'll be there as our friends. All of you, people can even have a dual citizenship. You have Japan passport, you have Nigerian passport. Whichever one you like, you use. If God helps us, but it's not something to do by force, or anybody can die about it. Yesterday, some governors were in Enugu. They were doing meeting with some people. They came up with some communique, which I even say here. Part of that communique I support. The other part I don't support. The one I support is condemning evil, condemning all those who are killing policemen, killing soldiers, burning police stations. I condemn that too. Anybody who kills policemen, kill soldiers, kill foreigners, kill our outside men for any reason, I condemn it. I also condemn even the cattle dealers who were in the bush with AK-47 killing our people. I condemn it too. It's not good. I'm using this opportunity that you people are here and now to tell you that peace must be returned to Imo State and Igbo land. And because of this, last time about a few days ago, about 3-4 days ago, the United Nations invited me as the leader of Biafra to speak on their platform, on their forum. That's the first time a Biafra leader was allowed to speak in the United Nations forum. I'm satisfied with that. I'm okay.
Yes.
It's because of my peaceful approach. They invited me. If I was the terrorist or violent, they wouldn't invite me. So with that, I have assumed the position of the father in this world to bring peace, to bring people together. And this peace and fatherly position I have taken today will bring peace in Igbo land to make this place sustain it. And because of this, I have forgotten to forgive all those who have offended me. Including Nnamdi Kanu.
Yes.
I was the person that appointed him. My representative in London. I went to London, opened the radio for him, appointed him to take care of that radio. The radio Biafra you are having of London belongs to me.
I know.
But along the line,
he changed.
But I forgive him now, today. Because of the father, I'm my father now, so recognized by the United Nations.
Yes.
I've gotten all I want. What is?
Nothing.
What is? I'm a father, and this will bring peace in Igbo land. Sometime ago, somebody asked me, a very prominent person, what will I forgive Nnamdi Kanu? Will I allow him to come back to me? I say, on one condition, if he denounces violence, if he stops preaching violence, I will accept him back. And I use this forum to ask him to stop preaching violence. To accept non-violence. We have an organization called the De facto, Biafran De facto for Somali Government. It's a peaceful organization. Why am I a member and my organization is a member? It's because they're peaceful. We are all peaceful. So I call him to come to that organization. To be part of it. Most of the problems he may face today, I will solve it for him. I will beg on his behalf.
Yes.
Let there be peace.
Yes, sir. Please. We need peace to be done.
It's not as if he has no point. He has some points. Our people are neglected. I started this struggle in 1999 because our people were being killed in the north because of the killing of our people. That time in Denmark, there was a cartoon against Prophet Muhammad. May soul rest in peace. Then our people were being killed in Kanu and all these places. For something that happens in Denmark, what is our problem with that? So I didn't like it. I said, okay, fine. Instead of our people to be killed, let us stay on our own. That was exactly also what Ojukwu did. So I want to start the process of bringing peace in Igbo land. I want to start the process. I will never criticize anybody again. I've never talked against anybody again. And through this process now, none of my members will criticize anybody. Yeah. I will make sure that I calm Nnamdi Kanu down.
Yeah.
He's my boy. He has been my boy.
Yes.
And but all of a sudden, you know, everybody likes popularity and all that. I don't hold it against him. What I don't buy against the governors, the one I say I will say against them. You don't come out in the open to say you disown your own people. You tell the world you disown those who are sitting for Biafra because you want to please your masters in Abuja.
And displease your own home.
They know that you are not telling the truth. Those people you want to please know that you are not telling them the truth. Just last time, Chief, former governor of Imo said, came up and said that during his regime, that he gave Biafra Group 500 million. I know many of you must have.
You saw it. Yes.
You see? He gave Biafra Group 500 million naira. Why didn't he say it that time he was the governor? He didn't say it, but he's saying it today because no more the governor. Most of these governors today who are disowning Biafra groups, they're doing the same thing. But lying. They're playing those tricks. They know that they are lying. We know so many of them who are sponsoring all this insurgency, all this insecurity. Many of them are sponsoring it. Okay, you know Governor Hope of Emma now, the governor of Imo State. He said last time that preliminary investigation into the crisis in Obele, the breaking of government house, police station, and prisons, was by politicians. You said it, by politicians. Who are these politicians?
Yeah.
The former governors, former members of the House of Reps, and the senators, they are the people doing all these things.
Yeah,
that even the people using all these programs groups that are violent to perpetrate all these things. But even they come, they hide, play those streets as if people don't know them. So these people, these things are bad. That behavior, I don't agree with them. We know what is democracy. If you say you believe in one Nigeria, fine, demonstrate it.
Yes.
By bringing peace.
Yes,
demonstrate it, not talk by mouth. You say if you want one Nigeria, who did you consult? Somebody like me, I started the struggle in 1999. You are being in a meeting, you are meeting in the Enugu, you never invited me. Yeah, you say you believe in one Nigeria. Did you ask those who said they want Biafra, why they are saying they want Biafra? You never asked us. That's not democracy.
It's not democracy.
They are saying it. Because they know that many of them were not elected democratically. I know how many of them we arranged their elections. Governor Kulocha himself, it was in my house, in my parlor in the village. I gave him the ticket of Abga in 2011. Single-handedly, we disqualified all those because of people told me that time to choose anybody I like in Imo State and make the governor. He gave me the ticket of that Abga. I gave it to Kulocha. Not just Kulocha. I was the person that gave him ticket of Abga in my parlor. Well ahead of those who were. They were not even the member of Abga.
Yes.
Well ahead of many other people.
Other candidates.
We managed his election. Managed the election for him to win. Managed. I know what I mean by managed against PDP. For him to win that election. It was arranged election. Is it in Anambra State? We brought somebody, a retiree, somebody who retired from his job as a banker in America. Tickets gave to him ahead of all governorship aspirants. He was not a member of Africa. We gave him the ticket and managed to make him win. He won. There are the people now in the coasting as Ipob leaders. Yeah? We know how we manage all of them. None of them has ever won any election. They were the elections you are with, all of them. Who are priding themselves today as the governors of Southeast. They are all rigged elections. Not a single one of them won the one election in Southeast. I challenge them. So, and they know that people don't listen to them.
Yes.
I was the first person that introduced the sick at home in 2004, August. It was over. The president that Obasa just said that when BBC asked him what happened, that they have shops were closed everywhere, even in Lagos, he said, Ipob, we are doing New Year Festival. I stopped it because I used it to try my popularity in Ipob land. I started with other programs. But now we kind of continued. Even develop more on it. Can any government, all of them, join together, do it at home? Okay, let them take a date. And tell Ipob to stay at home if they think they are popular in Ipob land and people are listening to them. Nobody will listen to them. Because they are corrupt.
They are corrupt and they are evil.
Corrupt and evil. Okay, take for instance, how many of them have an audited account of the money that is even from Abuja? Allocation. Let them publish the allocation they are receiving and make it known to us. And tell us the ones that are collected on behalf of local governments, how much they are giving the local governments. They cannot do it because they are corrupt. Look at the ones who call themselves senators. From even the deputy senate president, they were giving the contract to rehabilitate Enugu or Fakwa Expressway, Enugu Onisha Expressway. They had the money, used the money to buy houses in Dubai, London, America, France, everywhere, and private jets. We know all these things. But that are the people who gathered in Enugu yesterday to talk of Igbo leadership, to talk of one Nigeria. How many people have they employed? How many people have you used the money you are collecting from Abuja as allocation to create avenue for employment? Nobody.
A scholarship or
the scholarship, nothing. They're corrupt people. Ndoshi, thieves. But they come, they talk. So we shall not listen to this type of people. Now, last time I announce your account number. How many of them have paid money?
No corrupt one night.
They can't. Since I went to Ariwa House and made peace, how many of them have called me to say, Raf, thank you. Not talk of. Look at Rogers Okorocha, he gave ticket to be governor. For 8 years he was governor, he never gave me one naira. But as I was saying, he gave one. Biafra group 500 million. How much did he give that person who gave you tickets? One naira. I challenge you. I'm saying it. He didn't call me for 8 years. That time I was living in works. Until I passed over here, it's over 10 years now I passed into this place. He had not been here. This somebody gave a ticket. So, peace must exist among us.
Amen.
And the peace must be real.
Yes.
Not fake. In the night, you go and instigate people to come and fight. Outside. In the day, you say, no. It must be real. Anything you want me to do for you, I will do for you. All these people, that's why I want Probiafra groups to come together. If Probiafra groups come together, these people will not be in government. We remove all of them. We have a standard Biafra group. Biafra de facto customary government. Nnamdi Kanu is the only person remaining from coming into that